Hello people, in this video we want to look at heterophile antigens. So heterophile antigens. So what are these antigens? Some special type of antigens? So heterophile antigens are type of heteroantigens that present in two different species. In two different species you have two different types of antigens, but they share the same epitopes. So let us try to understand again. Look at this diagram here. This is an antigen and this is an antigen. Two antigens here. In two different species, two different antigens. Heteroantigens. Now these heteroantigens are becoming what? Heterophile antigens. How? Because they have the same epitope. Now what you will ask, what is epitope? Epitope is actually the part that binds to the antigen. Epitope of an antigen is the part of the antigen that binds to the antibody. Let's look at that. Look at this diagram here. This green thing you see is an antibody. So now this antibody wants to trap the antigen. This is the antigen. If it has to trap this antigen, it can bind only at this epitope. You see this? Can you see? This epitope is made to bind here. So this antigen also has epitope that can bind to this antibody. This antibody can bind to this antigen also. So these two become heterophile antigens because they have the same epitope and can bind to the same antibody. Okay? So people, are you ready to look at it again? Heterophile antigens are types of heteroantigens that are present in two different species, but they share epitopes with each other. What is epitope? Epitope is the part of an antigen. It's the part of an antigen to which the antibody attaches itself. Epitope is the part of the antigen to which the antibody attaches. Okay? Antibody produced against antigen of one species can react with others and vice versa. So the antibody, you are producing an antibody against this antigen, the same antibody can fight with this antigen also. Or there is another way of putting it, guys. Guys, what are we looking at today? Just take a wake-up call. We are looking at heterophile antigens. So basically, we are still looking at what happens to this antibody. This antibody can trap this antigen. This antibody can trap this antigen also. So if you want to detect this antibody in some person, you can either do it with the help of this antigen or this antigen. Any antigen you can use. So such tests are actually available. They're like, I know this will cross-react with this because the epitopes are same. So you can detect the antibody using any of these antigens. So those become those tests. Okay, we'll come to that. Basically, have you understood the concept? The concept you have understood, right? What heterophile antigens are. They are antigens which can bind to the same antibody because they have the same epitope. Okay. So what are the applications of heterophile antigens? Heterophile antigens can be used in various serological tests. A serological test means you will detect antibody, antigen. Those are serological tests. So various serological tests, you can employ these heterophile antigens. Antibody against one antigen can be detected in patient serum by employing a different antigen, which is a heterophile antigen. So basically, this a person is infected with this antigen, let us say, and he has made this antibody. Now you take his serum, okay, take a blood test, so you'll take his serum, and now you want to detect this antibody. What you do, you just add a few drops of this antigen. This will agglutinate. These two will agglutinate because they are heterophile antigens. Then you will know, okay, so either he has this antigen in him or he has this antigen in him. You are sure that he has either this antigen or this antigen. By his symptoms, obviously, you will know which antigen it is. So basically, this is the diagnostic application of heterophile antigen. You don't have to have this antigen only all the time. You can know that, wait, this antigen will cross-react with many other antigens. So we'll do one thing. We'll just check if it is having the same epitope. The same thing you will apply in Weils-Felix reaction, Paul-Bernal test, and cold agglutination test and streptococcus MG test. So which are the three tests that you are going to use this heterophile antigens? You can use in Weils-Felix test, Paul-Bernal test, cold agglutination and streptococcus MG test. Okay. So these are the three examples, the uses of heterophile antigens: Wiels-Felix reaction, Paul Bernal test, cold agglutination test, and Streptococcus MG test. Fine, moving on. Heterophile antigens. So first let us look at what this Wiels-Felix reaction is. A very brief into these. We are not going into the details. Guys, Wiels-Felix reaction is done to diagnose typhus fever. Who causes typhus fever? So typhus fever is actually caused by rickettsial bacteria. So basically what you can do is antibodies against rickettsial antigens are detected using Proteus antigens. It's pretty clear, right? So this person has rickettsial infection, he got typhus fever. His body made antibodies to this antigen of rickettsia. Now what you are going to do, you are going to do extract his blood, get the serum, and in that serum now still antibodies are there to rickettsia. What you do, you take a Proteus antigen and you put on this antibody and there will be agglutination reaction, Wiels-Felix reaction. Why? Because both of them are heterophile antigens, that's all. You understood, right? So this was Wiels-Felix reaction. Now let us move on to Paul Bernal test. So this is done for infectious mononucleosis, which is caused by Epstein-Barr virus. So this is a viral disease. Epstein-Barr virus causes infectious mononucleosis. Epstein-Barr virus is what type of virus? It's a DNA virus. So here what they will do, they will collect sheep RBCs, okay, and they will cross-react it with the antibodies in patient's sera. So let us try to understand this. So they are taking what? Guys, understand this, okay? There is a man who is having infection of EBV, Epstein-Barr virus. His body is now attacked with the antigen of Epstein-Barr virus. So he has the antigen of Epstein-Barr virus in him. His body now made antibodies against this antigen of Epstein-Barr virus. Okay. Now, you are going to take his blood, get his serum. In his serum, there is this antibody to Epstein-Barr virus. You are going to detect it by just adding sheep RBCs. Sheep RBCs have antigens on them which are similar to the antigens on Epstein-Barr virus. Interesting. The sheep doesn't seem to be infected with Epstein-Barr virus. So this is what? This is Paul Bernal test, okay? For infectious mononucleosis. So, what is the advantage that you are seeing here? You can just take sheep RBCs and detect infectious mononucleosis. No need to go and find an antigen of Epstein-Barr virus at all. Nice, right? Currently, it looks like the sheep is not at all infected. This is normal RBCs of sheep which are agglutinating with the antibodies made against Epstein-Barr virus. So guys, our intention was to look at three tests, correct? What and all were the three tests? Wiels-Felix test, we did already for typhus fever. Then we wanted to look at Paul Bernal test, infectious mononucleosis. This is done. One more is there now, cold agglutination test and Streptococcus MG test, correct? So shall we go to this one now? Okay. Cold agglutination test and Streptococcus MG test. This is for detection of primary atypical pneumonia. So here what they are telling, antibodies against Mycoplasma pneumonia are detected using human O blood group RBC and Streptococcus MG antigens respectively. Shouldn't be difficult. So this person has infection with what? This person has infection with Mycoplasma pneumoniae. Right? This is the problem. Now he is going to make antibodies against this Mycoplasma pneumoniae. He made antibodies against Mycoplasma pneumoniae. Now you are going to do a blood test, get his serum, get his antibodies, and now you are going to test the agglutination with which antigen? So you will take the RBCs, human RBCs, okay? Let's write here, human RBCs, human RBCs itself you will take of O blood group, that will have the I antigen, okay? At 40 degrees centigrade, that is at a very cold temperature, there will be agglutination with this antibody, okay? So this is cold agglutination, that's why it's called cold. Or you can use chilled suspension of Streptococcus MG. This is a group F streptococcus. This is a bacteria, right? You will use bacteria itself to detect another bacteria, or you can use human RBC to detect this bacteria. And remember, this is not specific. You are detecting something with something else, not specific tests these are. So that much you have understood already, right? So basically, this is heterophile cold agglutination test. You can use human RBCs or you can use streptococcus. That time it will become streptococcus MG test. So the antigen which is there on Mycoplasma pneumoniae is glycolipid antigen, okay? So it's a glycolipid antigen marked here, guys. So pay attention here. So Mycoplasma pneumoniae, glycolipid antigen, you can detect using human RBC or you can use streptococcus MG antigen, fine? So that is how you are going to do cold agglutination test or streptococcus MG test. So remember, this is non-specific detection. So hope you have understood all these tests. Let us take a recap. Heterophile antigens are nothing but antigens that have same epitope. So they are going to react, they share the same epitope, so they can agglutinate with similar antibodies. Coming to the uses, you can use them in Weil-Felix reaction, Paul-Bunnell test, cold agglutination test and streptococcus MG test, okay? So what exactly happens in Weil-Felix reaction? This is done to detect rickettsia in typhus fever. So you will use which antigen? Protease antigen you can use, okay? Or if you have rickettsial antigen, use that only, no problem. Coming to Paul-Bunnell test to detect Epstein-Barr virus and infectious mononucleosis, you can just use sheep RBCs. That's it, just sheep RBCs. Coming to cold agglutination test and streptococcus MG test to detect the glycolipid antigen from Mycoplasma pneumoniae, you can use human RBCs at 4 degrees centigrade, cold, or chilled suspension of streptococcus MG. That's all. So that was about heterophile antigens. These are non-specific detections. Guys, there's one more example actually. Treponema pallidum also is considered a non-specific antigen because it can react. The antibodies to this Treponema pallidum can react with the beef heart antigen. So the antibody against Treponema pallidum can be detected by the reaction with beef heart antigen, okay? So this is another example if you want to know. So we are hoping that the concept about heterophile antigens, this concept is clear, okay? We will meet you in the next video. Enjoy, bye-bye.